Hi everyone, it's Dr. Sloan. I just want to talk to you a little bit about peak and trough for antibiotics. I mentioned this before, but it's so much easier for me to just show you by actually drawing something for you. Unfortunately, I don't have a MAR that I can call up, but let's just say I had on a MAR vancomycin. Let's say it gets ordered for my patient that has a severe infection, IV every 8 hours. And then you'll usually see something like this. Peak and trough with third dose. And third dose is usually enough doses that we can accurately measure the level of the drug, sort of the steady state of drug in the body. And so if you did it after the first dose, obviously it would not have built up high enough the drug levels. Second dose, so third dose is kind of the key. So I just want to show you, let's just say that we start with this first dose at 0800. Okay, this is number one, right? And number two dose, again, this isn't what it would look like on your MAR, but it wouldn't be at 1400. It would be, what time would it be at, guys? 8 hours. It would be at 1600, okay? And then dose number three would be, oh so lucky, 2400, or depending on how your hospital does it, okay, midnight. So this is your third dose, and this is where we are going to focus drawing our peak and trough. So you're going to go get the appropriate tube colors for drawing a peak and trough. And once you have those tubes, then you need to plan out as a nurse when you're going to draw this. So the trough is always drawn just before you give the dose, okay? Before dose. And the dose, which number of dose it is, depends on the order, right? So for us, it's the third dose, okay? So it's drawn just before. So literally, you can come in, you can have your antibiotic, your vancomycin, but you can have your tubing for drawing your trough, you can, and your label, and you're going to go ahead and draw your trough. And once it's drawn, then you can hang your antibiotic. Okay, so let's say vancomycin goes up at 2400. All right, let's say we drew this at like 2350, just for kicks, just time wise. Okay, 2400, up goes vanco, and it's going to go in over 90 minutes. What time is it going to be finished? What time are we going to know that our vancomycin is done and fully infused into our patient? Well, if we started at 2400 and it goes for 90 minutes, 60 minutes would be 0100 plus another 30 minutes would be 0130, right? So now 0130 vanco infusion complete. Okay. So now the question is, when do we draw our peak? We're going to draw our peak 1 hour after the infusion is complete. Okay. So 1 hour after this is 0230. And now we're going to draw our peak. Okay. So peak is always 1 hour after drug infusion complete. Whoops. Okay. So I hope that that makes sense. The trough is drawn. Remember, this is the lowest point of the drug in the blood. And it's going to be drawn just before this third dose. And then the peak is going to be drawn 1 hour after this drug is done infusing. And so then with this peak and trough, pharmacy will go and they'll do pharmacokinetics on it, and they will find out whether the level is correct. So one of the things you want to keep your eyeball out for, this is an eyeball, you want to keep a watch for vanco levels, right? And if you don't see it on your shift, then you want to alert oncoming shift nurse that they were drawn, all right? Now, sometimes you'll know this, you know, you're on the day shift and the peak and trough gets ordered, but it's not going to happen on your shift. So you just want to make sure you let the night shift know. They should know anyway by looking at their orders, but you just want to look at it. Let's say that these levels come back and they're high. And let me just change my color here. And these come back and they are too high. They're too high, then they're probably going to lower the dose of vanco. Okay. And then once they lower the dose of vanco, then they're going to go ahead and do another peak and trough after third dose. Okay, so this is how we adjust these antibiotics that basically have a narrow therapeutic index, right? And for whom there's high levels of toxicity if they are not in that, exactly in that narrow, in that therapeutic index range. So again, same thing could happen here. If we got our vanco levels back and they were too low, we might increase the dose of vanco, and then again, peak and trough after third dose. So don't be surprised if on your test, you have a question about a drug that needs a peak and a trough, and when would you draw the peak and when would you draw the trough? Okay, because you need to be able to know that. You need to be able to figure that out. It's something that you will do in your preceptorships. It's something that's part of the role of the nurse. All right, guys, I hope that